Welcome back to Bard's Tale 3. This is Jay Rodman, and I'm not actually playing live this time again. I decided to mop up Sierra Brania. I always want to call it Brianna, but it's Brania. So what I meant by that is I wanted to go into every building and make sure I didn't miss anything. It also gives me a chance to get a little extra experience. And mostly complete the map, which was the main motivator for me. So this is playing at double speed. I started out at what is it? It's not a hospital, it's the temple. And got my old status cleared away. And proceeded to kick down the door of every. I think of them as hunting lodges because when you see the interior decor of these buildings, they just always got their stag's head mounted on the wall. So somehow this is just, to me, a city of all, Middle Ages playboys who go out hunting on the weekend. Maybe that's where they all are. Anyway, I guess I don't have things to say about all points of this. I'll cut in when I have anything to comment on. Here at being kicked back to being old again after the very first fight. I started to try to put up with it for a little while, but pretty soon I give in and just run back to the temple and have him take it off. some reason with an approach of doing all of the inner buildings first and doing the outer buildings afterwards. I think mostly because it let me be very lazy about keeping track of which building I was in. Approach I'm using to these fights and mapping is to explore until I get into a fight, set up the fight, and then while the fight is scrolling, do the map upkeep. I don't always keep the juggling on target, but it allowed me to not spend too much time waiting for one thing or the other. First pair of war gloves, and I upgraded Lady Oakshield's hand protection from the base start of the game gauntlets to the war gloves, which kicks her up 3 armor class points all at once. I was pretty happy about that. Still don't have glove upgrades for my bard though. Could really use some mithril gauntlets. Gloves, whatever they're called. To go ahead and draw the walls for all of the buildings I was going to encounter for the rest of the town. A fair amount of effort trying to figure out whether adamant chain was an upgrade for anyone. I was hoping my rogue could wear it over, you know, as a replacement for her mithril chain. And I decided it's a little fancier than mithril scale, even though it has the same armor class, so my bard ends up wearing it for style points. I do wonder, what's the point of Mithril Chain if it's not the best equipment for anyone at any time? House turns out to be more packed with monsters than I thought possible. I think I fight two fights and then decide I want to move on with my life. So the third fight I run from. And then the fourth fight I run from. And the fifth fight I run from. And I don't remember whether it was six or seven or eight. It just felt like some kind of clown car experiment. Is at this point I'd entirely lost track of where I was across the bottom row. I just figured I'd get to the end eventually, and if anything interesting happened along the way, I would figure out where it had happened afterwards. There's a complete map. It's kind of a feeling of satisfaction in that. So at the end of this, I move our party to the Sacred Grove, where our next adventure will take place.